move into a few of these use cases where we can kind of explore exactly how the product works and what kind of information that it presents. Here in understanding network latency, what we're looking at here is a map, a topology map of a customer's network. This has actually got a number of different routing areas on it. We're looking at different locations that are then connected by, you know, a set of core links. And traditionally, you know, a lot of times you'll have what we call a source destination ticket. That typically starts when there's a source and destination that for some reason are not responding as expected. Maybe you've gotten an alert that latency is shot up. We need to understand because we're now outside of our control windows and we need to understand what the impact was. So in this case, what I'll do is I'm just going to highlight and search for a source destination between Chicago and LA in these particular set of substations for a large provider. As I go in here, selecting here my ORDP 124 and the LAXP 104, you'll see the dark green solid arrows are showing me what my forward direction path is. So that tells me how my traffic is moving from one location to the other. And then the dashed set of arrows tells me how that traffic is moving back to that site. So we do reflect all of the symmetric and asymmetric routes that are happening in your network. We can provide great insight there to show you where you have unmatched latency issues on the bidirectional paths. In addition to seeing here on the return path, we can also see these little tunnel icons. That's telling me that there's an RSVPTE tunnel that's actually controlling that path in addition to the routing. So we know there's been a configuration change. We have that captured, and we can say this is exactly why this path is resolving the way it is at this particular point in the network. Now, in this case, the customer is complaining about this service delivery, but it was about an hour ago. So we can go back and let's move time. So I'm going to come up here to my time window, just time back about 30 minutes, and I'll see what was going on at that particular time. In this case, we can see that these little red lines are telling me that there was an adjacency failure. That's actually when the routers, you could call it a routing flap, but that's when the routers are still connected, but they're unable to pass traffic. And that's the level of visibility that we provide because we're in the control plane, as opposed to, you know, does a ping work or does an SNMP get work? We're actually listening at the control plane and can say, guys, these guys are still up. But unfortunately, they're not passing traffic across this link, and the link has changed, and this is the new path. Now, in this particular case, we can see all these new hops. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click the drill-in button so that I can isolate the devices and links related to this particular service path. When I do that, I see this particular path. Here, I'm actually looking at 1050, so this was my good path. Notice here, I'm sitting on my timeline at 1050, and this is showing my good path direct from Chicago out to LA. All my latencies are low. Everything's in good shape. I'm going to hit the play button here, and then we're going to move through time and see what happened to this particular service. Now, as I hit that play button, what we notice is about 5-6 minutes in, the path changes, and this is where we go. The gray path is actually showing us what the previous path was. We can see that adjacency failure in red, so now the green path is showing me what the new path is and how it's moving from one edge to the other edge of the network. In this particular case, we can still tie all the latency for the path, and we can see latency's gone up a little bit. There's a few more hops, but it seems to be recovering and providing service. As I continue to play, though, we'll notice that as that adjacency failure causes traffic to reroute in the network, we start to see congestion coming up on the links, and we start to see queuing delay and latency delay impacting our services and our network latency across that path. You can see here it shoots up to 775 milliseconds. We've got over 3/4 of a second in latency, way outside of what's needed and expected from a control perspective, and we'd be in big trouble. Now, from our capability, we can actually look and see what caused that congestion. You know, it was normally running about 40%, suddenly shoots up to 90. We now have the information to go, yes, there was a particular latency issue. It happened about 30 minutes ago. We can actually look at it and say, now when this adjacency fails, we need to make sure that the path reroutes a different direction in the network. So we take a different path and can resolve that so that we engineer that solution so that it will not happen again. All of this kind of predicated on the ability to go back in time and even see the issue, because at the time that we were sitting in real time, everything looked good, it had recovered. We had no clue until we moved back in time to see exactly what that issue was.